بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله الواحد المنعم والصلاة والسلام على محمد سيد الأنام وعلى آله الكرام وصحبه العظام وسلم تسليما كثيرا ما دام يجري هذا النظام وبعد قال تبارك وتعالى وما الحياة الدنيا إلا متاع الغرور وقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم كم من صائم ليس له من صيامه إلا الجوع وكم من قائم ليس له من قيامه إلا السهر أو كما قال عليه الصلوات والتسليمات. Respected brothers, elders, mothers, sisters, and youngsters, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. We begin as always by praising the Almighty, and we send the choicest blessings upon the final messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, peace and blessings upon him. We are in the blessed season of the month of Ramadan. We pray and we supplicate that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shower his mercy upon each and every one of us, accept our fasting, our devotional acts, our self-reflection, and our charity. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make this month a means of our positive transformation. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bring the best of khair and goodness to ourselves and the entire humanity as we pass these blessed days in these challenging moments. Ameen ya Rabbal Alameen. In general, hunger is something that humanity fears. Humanity fears hunger, humanity fears thirst. So when it comes to our hunger when we are fasting, and when it comes to our hunger and our thirst when it comes to fasting, when it is done with an intention, it entails rewards and blessings, and it becomes an act of worship. So in general, hunger is something that people fear. But when we remain hungry for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it becomes an act of worship, whereupon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promises forgiveness and blessings. And fasting in reality is such a profound act of worship that the rewards are endless. The Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings upon him, says, فَإِنَّهُ لَا مِثْلَ لَهُ. For indeed there is nothing in terms of an act of worship like fasting. Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu, in a detailed narration, speaks about the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam highlighting the rewards of fasting. And he says, لَخَلُوفُ فَمِ الصَّائِمِ أَطْيَبُ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ مِنْ رِيحِ الْمِسْكِ. That even the odor that comes out from the stomach of the fasting person, it is more beloved to the Almighty than musk. And the Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings upon him, says, look at the dedication and the commitment of those who are fasting. إِنَّمَا يَذَرُ شَهْوَتَهُ وَطَعَامَهُ وَشَرَابَهُ مِنْ أَجْلِي. That this servant and this slave of mine is leaving and abandoning his or her temptations and his or her desire for food and drink for my sake. So therefore, I will exclusively give the rewards. So again, we learn from this that fasting is no ordinary activity. Being in the month of fasting is a profound. And we continue to pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us with the reality and the blessings and the bounties related to fasting and Ramadan. Ameen ya Rabbal Alameen. A famous narration I quoted in commencement, where the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, كَمْ مِنْ صَائِمٍ لَيْسَ لَهُ مِنْ صِيَامِهِ إِلَّا الْجُوعِ وَكَمْ مِنْ قَائِمٍ لَيْسَ لَهُ مِنْ قِيَامِهِ إِلَّا السَّهْرِ. The loose translation of this narration is that there are many who fast, but they attain nothing from their fasting other than hunger. And there are many who stand in prayer, and they attain nothing from their standing in prayer except being awake. So what we learn from this is that when we do something, we should do it to its optimum. If there's a goal that you and I have in life and we're working towards it, we want to attain it with quality. We want to attain it to its perfection. We do everything. As they say, we cross all the T's and dot all the I's, meaning that we're doing it so precisely because we want the end result to be perfect. and to be splendid and to be outstanding. So we are going through the activity of fasting. We don't want to just fast by remaining hungry. And we don't want to just do qiyam and taraweeh by standing in prayer and being awake. Rather, we want the essence of fasting. We want the essence of qiyam. We want the true meaning of the month of Ramadan. And in one aspect, one of the spirits of fasting, one of the objectives of fasting is to learn self-discipline. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Holy Quran describes the obligation of fasting, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامُ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. That, O you who believe, fasting has been prescribed upon you as it was prescribed upon the communities before you. But then here's the objective, لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ, so that you may attain taqwa, so that you may attain self-discipline, so that you may attain the mindfulness of the Almighty. So this is the objective and the spirit of fasting, is that we learn self-restraint. It's in the nature of the human being to be attached to things. We get attached to wealth, we get attached to people, we get attached to ideologies, we get attached to movements, and we get attached to entertainment and fun. So as human beings, we have this nature in us to be attached to things, to be attached to people, to be attached to wealth and commodities, etc. But fasting teaches us we have to detach to get attached to Allah. We have to detach, we have to somewhat stay distant from these things, and learn that our true happiness is with the Almighty, is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's why the Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings upon him, he describes the situation of a believer. And Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, famous companion, the son of Umar ibn al-Khattab, he mentions this narration. He says, once I was with the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And many a times when we experience something, we remember everything related to that experience. So Abdullah ibn Umar says, before he talks about the hadith, he says, I remember the Prophet ﷺ was with me and he put his hand on my shoulder. So one of the reasons why he's saying this is that he says, I vividly remember every aspect of what the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam told me, that I even remember how he put his hand on my shoulder. أَخَذَ بِمَنْكَبَيْ. The Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings upon him, put his hands on my shoulder. And then he said to me that when it comes to this worldly life and the attachments of the worldly life, I advise you of something very important. And that's the message of the spirit of fasting as well. The Prophet ﷺ told Abdullah ibn Umar, كُنْ فِي الدُّنْيَا كَأَنَّكَ غَرِيبٌ أَوْ عَابِرُ سَبِيلٌ. That when it comes to your attachment of this world and the worldly things, be like a stranger, or be like someone who's a traveler. Now let's dissect and unpack what the Prophet ﷺ is telling Abdullah ibn Umar. He's saying, be like a stranger or be like a traveler. So when we go to a place where we don't know too many people, when we go to a region where we don't have much work there, then we just pass by. Whatever is required, we use, we take, and then we move on to our destination. And similarly, the traveler is moving from one point to another. They're not establishing all kinds of things in the 2-hour transit that they have in an airport. Rather, they're just waiting for the time to pass, and on their mind is the destination. So the Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings upon him, is teaching us here through Abdullah ibn Umar that yes, we have affiliations in this world. We can't live in this world without wealth. We cannot live in this world without interacting with other human beings. We have to be attached to our families, our spouses, our children, etc. We have to have objectives in life in terms of the world. But it should not become the absolute objective. Rather, there should be some distance. What should be closer to our hearts than all of these things is our connection with the Almighty. So that if we ever lose the worldly things of this world, the material of this world, the wealth of this world, if we ever lose a loved one, if we ever are detached from anything physical that we are attached to, then our love to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is so profound that it won't disturb us to the point that we become so depressed that we cannot function. Rather, our attachment with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is immense, is so strong that it allows us to continue. And we know that if we have Allah, we have everything. And if we've lost the Almighty, then really we have lost everything despite having everything. So this is one of the messages of fasting. Imam al-Ghazali rahimahullah, he says there are three types of people who fast. There are three types of people who fast. The first level, he says, is those people who are fasting, they only remain hungry. So they stop eating at suhoor and then they start eating at iftar. There's no other activity that is changing their life while they are fasting. So he says, this is also a person who's fasting. They will be rewarded for their fasting and they have fulfilled their obligation. And then he says, there's a second level of fasting. And that second level of fasting is that they remain hungry and thirsty, etc. But they also incorporate some actions with their fast. So they're reciting Quran, they're standing in prayer, they're performing their prayers. So there are actions, additional actions attached to their fasting. So this is the second level of fasting. And he says that Imam al-Ghazali rahimahullah says that this is also a great merit of fasting, that the fasting promotes positive activity. And then he says, there's a khassatul khass. There's an elite group of those who fast. And he says they do the previous two things. They stay hungry and thirsty. They also add activities to their lives. But he says they develop taqwa. They develop God consciousness. Their fasting gives them the power to get closer to the Almighty and abstain from their bad habits and let go of their sin, let go of their attachments that are distracting them from the Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And similarly, there's a similar statement in reference to Zuhud by Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal rahimahullah. Imam ibn Ahmad says that if we don't have zuhud in our lives, it's difficult to be amongst those who are the muqarrabeen, those who are very close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So what is zuhud? Zuhud literally means to be detached, to be distant. So he says there's three levels of zuhud. And you'll see how they interchange here with what Imam al-Ghazali rahimahullah said. So he says, we all have to abstain from the unlawful and the forbidden. So the first level of zuhud is we stay away and we abstain from the haram. We stay away from the forbidden. That is the first level of zuhud. The second level of zuhud is to abstain from something halal because that will help us stay away from the haram. To abstain from something halal. So it's permissible. Allah has given us the permission to engage in doing it, but we stay away from it because we know by doing that halal, it may lead to something haram. Some of you may be asking, how is this possible? So let me give you an example. So if I know that if I go to this specific locality or this place, there's nothing wrong in traveling the earth. You can go anywhere. Siru fil ard. Allah says, travel and traverse the earth. So, but I know if I go to this specific locality or this specific place, I'm going to end up being around wrong people. That's going to incite me in doing haram activities because I went there. But if I keep myself away from that place, I know I won't be around those people or that sinful environment. So I will protect myself. So if I stay away from that region or that locality or that place or those people, even though it's permissible for me to travel there, I stay away from the halal because I know by going there it may lead to haram. So he says this is the second level of zuhud, is that we even stay away from some things that are permitted. Some things that are permissible we abstain from, to refrain ultimately from the forbidden. And then he says, the third level of zuhud is to stay away from anything that distracts one from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Anything that turns us away from our Creator, the Almighty, anything positive, we stay away from anything that distracts us from the Almighty. So again, we want to do things in the way that is required. And fasting, mashallah, many of us are fasting, many of us are spending the blessed month of Ramadan, and I know all of you are doing great works by reciting Quran, by fasting, by giving charity, by helping in the community, by doing additional prayers and acts of devotion. Keep all of this up, but also keep this in mind that we want to do the best of fasting. Just like we want to attain the best of positions, the best of wealth, the best of prosperity, the best of peace, the best of health as well, we want to do the best of fasting. And one method of doing this is to fast like those who are muttaqoon, those who have taqwa and those who have piety, by detaching, by keeping our distance away from things that are harmful for our lives in any aspect of the world or the hereafter. And as I conclude, a final hadith, a final reminder, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was once with a man. And Abu Abbas Sahal ibn Sa'd al-Sa'di radiyallahu anhu says that this man came to the Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings upon him, and he asked the question, دُلَّنِي عَلَىٰ عَمَلٍ إِذَا عَمِلْتُهُ أَحَبَّنِيَ اللَّهُ وَأَحَبَّنِيَ النَّاسِ. What a profound question. Tell me of an act, if I do this act, Allah will love me and the people will also love me. Allah will love me and the people will also love me. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, اِزْهَدْ فِي الدُّنْيَا يُحِبُّكَ اللَّهُ. Keep your distance from the material. Don't attach to it too much. And if you do this, Allah will love you. And keep your distance also away from what people have. Izhad fima inda nas. Whatever people have, don't be greedy for it. Don't look at the eye of greed, hasad, jealousy, etc. with what people have. And if you do this, people will love you. So what is in reality this that the Prophet ﷺ is asking for? He's saying that we need to detach. Detach from the love of the material and detach from what material others have. Allah will love us and people will love us as well. We make dua that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala empower us with the true meaning of fasting. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow us to fast like the elite. May Allah accept our prayers, our fasting and our charity. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the best in this world and the hereafter. At this point, I'm requesting all the brothers and sisters who are appointed for the line collection to kindly proceed, inshallah.
Assalamu alaikum. Today's generous donations are used for regular maintenance of the masjid, employee salaries, payment of utilities, extra cleaning and disinfecting the building. Jazakumullah for your continued support. To allow maximum congregants to pray Tarawih and Friday prayers, we have made arrangements in two buildings, one here, one across the street. At 431 Nugget School building. Please note there will be separate hufas for each of these two locations to lead the congregations. The management also reminds all brothers and sisters to come with wudu, bring your own mask, prayer mats, and cooperate with our volunteers all time. You are reminded to adhere to protocols of social distancing while entering the masjid, during the prayers, and while exiting the masjid premises, including while walking on the public sidewalks. We have been told that some people have contacted the COVID-19 people and still coming to the masjid. We really appreciate if you could possibly avoid coming here. We don't want, for your safety of you and safety of others, and we really respect and really appreciate you not coming to the masjid. If you have come in contact with anyone who has COVID-19 or you have any symptoms, so please don't come here. Also, please don't gather in the parking lot after the prayers, before or after the prayers. People are watching us. There are police cars watching us. We don't want the facility to be closed. Lastly, please watch our website for the current anti-government announcements for the religious places. Jazakum Allah khair. Assalamu alaikum.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. Ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. Hayya 'ala salah. حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله
الحمد لله الحمد لله الذي هدانا إلى سبيل الهداية والعرفان وجعلنا من أهل الإسلام والإيقان نحمده سبحانه وتعالى على أن أظلنا شهر عظيم يسمى رمضان ترمض فيه الذنوب وتكشف فيه الكروب ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له شهادة بالقلب واللسان ونشهد أن سيدنا ومولانا محمدًا عبده ورسوله الذي عرفنا ما يدخلنا الجنان صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه أكمل الأهل الإيمان وسلم تسليمًا كثيرًا أما بعد فقد دخل شهر رمضان فخذوا ببركاته بالطاعات والتنزه عن العصيان كما حضنا عليه رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إلى ما لا يتناهى من الزمان وقال صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا كان أول ليلة من شهر رمضان صفدت الشياطين ومردت الجن وغلقت أبواب النار فلم يفتح منها باب وفتحت أبواب الجنة فلم يغلق منها باب وينادي مناد يا باغي الخير أقبل ويا باغي الشر أقصر ولله عتقاء من النار وذلك كل ليلة للصائم فرحتان فرحة عند فطره وفرحة عند لقاء ربه ولخلوف فم الصائم أطيب عند الله من ريح المسك والصيام جندة أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم فالآن باشروهن وابتغوا ما كتب الله لكم وكلوا واشربوا حتى يتبين لكم الخيط الأبيض من الخيط الأسود من الفجر ثم أتموا الصيام إلى الليل بارك الله لنا ولكم في القرآن العظيم ونفعنا وإياكم بالآيات والذكر الحكيم إنه تعالى جواد كريم ملك بر رؤوف رحيم إن الحمد لله نحمده تعالى ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله تبارك وتعالى عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وبارك وسلم تسليما كثيرا كثيرا أما بعد فيا أيها الناس أوصيكم ونفسي أولا بتقوى الله والمواظبة على ذكر الله ألا خير الكلام كلام الله وأحسن الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وخير الأمور عوازمها وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم من صلى علي واحدة صلى الله عليه بها عشرة وقال تبارك وتعالى في القرآن المجيد والفرقان الحميد إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمد. قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: أرحم أمتي بأمتي أبو بكر، وأشدهم في أمر الله عمر، وأحياهم عثمان، وأقضاهم علي، وفاطمة سيدة نساء أهل الجنة، وحمزة أسد الله وأسد رسوله، وعلمهم بالحلال والحرام معاذ بن جبل، وأقرأهم لكتاب الله أبي بن كعب، وأفرضهم زيد بن ثابت، ولكل أمة أمين، وأمين هذه الأمة أبو عبيدة بن الجراح رضوان الله تعالى عليهم أجمعين. اللهم اغفر لنا وللمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات. اللهم انصر من نصر دين محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم واجعلنا منهم. اللهم اخذل من خذل دين محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم ولا تجعلنا معهم. عباد الله رحمكم الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله العلي العظيم يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن محمد رسول الله، أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي على الصلاة، حي على الصلاة، حي على الفلاح، حي على الفلاح. قد قامت الصلاة، قد قامت الصلاة. الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله.
استووا استقيموا، straighten your rows in your own spots. جزاكم الله خيرا. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. إن هذه تذكرة، فمن شاء اتخذ إلى ربه سبيلا. وما تشاءون إلا أن يشاء الله، إن الله كان عليما حكيما. يدخل من يشاء في رحمته، والظالمين أعد لهم عذابا أليما. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. إن
إِنَّ الْأَبْرَارَ لَفِي نَعِيمٍ وَإِنَّ الْفُجَّارَ لَفِي جَحِيمٍ يَصْلَوْنَهَا يَوْمَ الدِّينِ وَمَا هُمْ عَنْهَا بِغَائِبِينَ وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا يَوْمُ الدِّينِ ثُمَّ مَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا يَوْمُ الدِّينِ يَوْمَ لَا تَمْلِكُ نَفْسٌ لِنَفْسٍ شَيْئًا وَالْأَمْرُ يَوْمَئِذٍ لِلَّهِ الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله